All righty. Now, as you know, Connie Stevens was expected to be with us here in a very few moments. I must tell you that this little child has been rehearsing with us this afternoon with a terrible case of ptomaine poisoning. She's fine as far as any serious consequences, but we have just gotten a note, and she just simply can't make it. And we are grateful that she came down and insisted on going through rehearsals and said she was going to be all right, but she was apparently pushing herself too hard. But any relatives of hers or friends watching, don't worry. It's just a tiny tummy upset. So now what they have done is to send Betsy back, not even knowing what her secret's going to be, and she's going to have to stand in for Connie Stevens. So here we go. Let's meet Betsy Palmer. Hi, sweetie.
Hi.
Now, did anybody tell you anything? Don't say it out loud. Anybody give you any idea of what,
sure,
what you're supposed to do?
Yes. Well, I went on a shopping spree today, looking at a lot of spring clothes.
Looking at a lot of spring clothes.
Yes.
All right. And Betsy, in lieu of Connie Stevens, will do her best to describe all of these spring fashions to you.
Yes, but I have to tell you my secret.
All right.
First,
tell me what your secret is. Yeah. Oh, now, that's very interesting. Very interesting. Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Tell me more. All right, now we'll have to pretend that Betsy is Connie Stevens. And we're going to turn this whole thing over to the panel, and it concerns something that she did, and we'll start the questioning with Henry Morgan, please.
You know,
yeah,
there are at least three of these dummies I'd like to see again.
Beautiful group, aren't they?
Yeah, but there's more to it.
There's more to it?
There's more to a couple of them. Well, we get...
Yes.
Yes.
Have I ever seen you before, madam?
Ah, I've been a little close to you at times.
I see. And your secret is, I've got to
something
think you're
she
Connie
did.
Stevens,
something
right?
Something I did. Well, if I'm Connie.
If you're
yes.
Connie.
Mm-hmm.
And it's something you did today?
Yes, I did.
You, did you, make any, have anything to do with the manufacture of any clothing?
No, I did not, Mr. Morgan. No.
$20 down, $60 to go. We go, please, to Bess.
Well, Gary, you know, usually after a mannequin has been in a window and they start pulling it apart and taking arms off and legs off,
mm-hmm.
I think I'd like to tell the stagehands that there's one they should be very careful with.
Oh?
I think I see her breathing.
Henry sees two or three of them breathing, don't you, Henry?
I think you're all nuts.
I see one. We're nuts? Well... You want to take
ask
them home?
Ask me a question. Come on.
Is
you kids don't
them,
know how to play this game,
one of them
do you?
Breathing?
Is one of them breathing?
Yeah.
Yes.
One of them is breathing, yes.
But that's not my secret.
Let's hold what it is, and let's get to you describing the fashions. Did they
all
give
right.
you the cards that Connie
Stevens...
Yes,
I have them, yes.
And we will just pan from left to right.
The first is a lovely silk evening dress by Hattie Carnegie. And then there is a white lace dress, a junior sophisticate, designed by Anne Klein.
Mm-hmm.
And next we have a pale blue silk evening dress by Hannah Troy. And there's a short black velvet evening dress, which is trimmed with black boa feathers. That is also by Hannah Troy. And a beaded paisley sheath by Samuel Winston, designed by Roxanne. And Arthur Jablow's swashbuckler suit, designed by David Kidd. And finally, we have Maurice Rentner's pink silk harem costume designed by Bill Blass.
All righty. Now, Connie Stevens' secret was that she had a cup of coffee this evening with one of these mannequins. I think now, staring from close up, now that Henry had spotted it, we can see who it is. Her name is Gail del Corral, and she can do this by the hour. She once, on a telethon, did it for 8 hours.
I thought it was this one.
You thought it was the other one? Hold it just a minute. You thought it was the front one?
I thought it was that one.
Which other one did you think it was?
And the third, the first lady I was sure of.
Excuse me, I know this isn't polite.
Well,
that ain't real.
I had a castle in Spain just fell down.
And do you know experts? Mickey Rooney, lots of celebrated clowns have tried to make this young lady laugh, flicker her eyelash, change her expression. She's just fantastic. You can jump up and down and make... Now, I have a feeling, though, that she might go for the romantic approach, you know. I'm in the mood for love.
Simply because you're near me. Oh, look, I'm killing her. Darling, but when you're near me, I'm in the mood for love.
Gail del Corral. Do it once more, up real close.
Incredible.
She's amazing. I think, weren't you with Steve once with your daughter? Does she have a little girl?
Yes,
she does. Do the mechanical doll bits, you see?
Yes.
That's marvelous. How do you do it?
Oh, it's not very hard. It's a matter of self-discipline.
Well, I thought that when you know, if you didn't blink for, at least 20 times a minute, that your eyeballs got all unglued and stuff.
No, I even trained small children at Star Modeling School in New Orleans, and you tell them to watch something that's not moving. And I have a 4-year-old student that can go for 4 minutes without blinking.
All right, I'll tell you what we're going to do now. We'll see. You taught this to 4-year-old children. We'll see how you can do this with 4 somewhat older children. But we won't do that for just a moment yet. We will be back with you again in just a minute. But first, let's pause and listen to a word from a friend of mine. Now, before we get into our final little tableau here, and tableau is the word I hope it's going to turn out to be, let me emphasize to everyone, and particularly to friends and family of Connie Stevens, that there is nothing wrong with her except an upset tummy, and nobody can work when that's happening to you. And she has tried, and we are grateful. And Betsy, thanks for stepping in on no notice whatsoever.
Dear,
all right. And we'll have Connie back as soon as there is an open spot on the show. Now, what I want you to do is to pose the gentleman each in a pose. And don't forget, now we have about a minute and a half. You have to hold it through all that time, through the closing theme, and so forth. So you pose her.
Well,
pose him.
He looks like an Indian.
He should. He worked for one for a woman.
Okay, now bend over. Now you should be in the army. Let's salute. All righty.
Now, let me see.
What kind of Indian is this?
You stay still.
Stay where you are. Put your hand on your hip in the most graceful fashion. And then...
Oh, that kind of Indian.
That's lovely. It's lovely. Just the way you are. And look out at the audience, see? Now, Betsy, what can we do with you? Like as though you're fixing the back of your hair and sort of like under your chin. Fine. Now, do something with me. Okay, now you strike a pose. How much longer do we have, fellas? 30 seconds? Feels more like 30 minutes. Friends, next week on our show, we're going to have the great star of the Defenders, Mr. E.G. Marshall, as our guest. And so until then, this is Gary Moore speaking for all these dummies, saying be very kind to each other, will you? And goodbye out there.